Hey, good morning, everybody. Welcome back out to the property. Today we're going to start cutting some trees down. This right through here is where our driveway is going to be. And so you kind of see the orange ribbons. The orange ribbons on a few trees back through there behind me. And those are the trees we've marked that we're actually going to cut down for the road. And then we're going to get back into where the house is going to sit, start getting those trees on the ground so we can get it piled up, burn the brush, get the logs out of here, and get ready for digging the basement. I've got my cousin coming today to help me out. He's actually a professional tree cutter. He works for the United States Forest Service, so he's a wildland firefighter. Does this kind of stuff all the time, all over the country, fighting wildland fires and putting trees on the ground. So we're excited about that. Have him out here helping us today. And that's about it. All right, Drew, you're on video. The theory is when you're done falling all your trees, correct me if I'm wrong, but you want it to look like you've taken a comb and combed through your trees, right? They all lay together, because then it makes your cleanup way easier. It's not like you're not trying to undo a jigsaw puzzle at that point when you come in and try to clean all your trees up. So there is a lot of strategy in how you want to fall your trees to make it a lot faster and more efficient getting the trees out, getting the brush out, so you don't spend all your time sorting through the mess that you made falling your trees.
You want to make sure that your saw is tuned up and have a good sharp chain. There's nothing more dangerous than a dull chain.
And there's your pro tip from an official wildland firefighter man. All right, Drew, how big do you think this tree is?
32 inches. 32 DBH, probably 125 feet tall.
Biggest one of the day right here.
Yep.
Think you can reach your arms around it?
Nope.
All right, grand finale right here. He's going to face cut it to way to make it fall, hopefully where he wants it to. Cut the wedge out of the front, create a hinge in the middle of the tree, and then cut the backside and let it swing on that hinge and fall where you want it. Go time. Tree to fall right there. So he plunge cut into the side, left the hinge in it. You see a little bit of wood right there in the middle that's not cut, that's the hinge. He's gonna wedge it and hopefully push it over where he wants it to go, and he'll cut the little bit of wood back at the very back is all it's holding. As soon as he cuts that, once he wedges it, cuts that little piece on the back, the whole tree should hinge and fall right where it wants it. This right here is all that's holding the tree right now. As soon as it cuts that, it should roll. Roll, baby!
Let's do it!
Maybe not. Pound them wedges a little more.
Will move 100-foot tree 10 feet at the top when it's all the way in.
I didn't know that. It's a lot like work. Better get it before that wind picks back up. That's solid, man. That's unbelievable. Thank you.
it goes. Timber! Holy cow. Hey, it went exactly where you wanted it to go, big dog. Woo. Not bad for half day's work. Up here on a hickory stump, playing it hot. Devil went down to Georgia.
Stay right there so Hadley can come to you. Go, Hadley girl. Go to Corbin, Hadley. Go where Corbin is.
Those sticks hard to climb over.
No.
Corbin, did you get your new T-ball hat today?
Yes.
What color is it?
Purple.
Purple.
Dang it! What's he doing? What's Daddy doing? Yay! Can you say yay, Daddy?
This tree is bigger than the one at the church.